Mr. Trudeau, Sean Lethong, CHCH News. You've committed to a $10 billion short-term deficit while both your opponents are talking about balancing the books immediately. Why should Canadians deal with a deficit in the short term?
Our economy needs investment in order to create growth. Our plan features 3 years of historic involvement in the investment in the Canadian economy. That growth will eliminate the Harper deficit, and we will balance the budget in 2019. Now, Harper has us in recession and in deficit right now because he has been unable to grow the economy over the past years. Mr. Mulcair seems to want to agree with him and continue to not invest in the economy and even make cuts. We know that Canadians should be betting on their future and investing in the future, and that's exactly what our plan will do.
Mr. Trudeau, also on deficits, for days you've been saying now you don't know the size and scope of what you call Mr. Harper's mess. Today, you're saying that you will run a deficit over the next two fiscal years of $10 billion. If the economy deteriorates further, will you keep all of your promises, even if it means going beyond that $10 billion figure?
What the economy needs is a plan for growth and investment. And what Canadians need are leaders who will tell them the truth. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. We are committed to balancing the budget in 2019. We have a plan for growth so that the economy can get beyond Mr. Harper's deficits by 2019. That is what we are focused on.
Permit me to ask you another way. If you are getting a sense that the economy is deteriorating based on facts, will you then begin to start scaling back on your promises, dropping some of those promises, or will you say, no, I've made these promises during my campaign, and so even if it means going into the hole greater than $10 billion, I'll do it?
The Liberal plan is focused on creating investment in growth that is going to actually get Canadians into the jobs and the positive future they need. That is our focus. We are focused on creating that growth that is necessary so that we can grow back into balance out of Mr. Harper's deficit by 2019. And all the way through, I will be open and transparent and tell the truth about our plans. And I certainly hope that Mr. Harper and Mr. Mulcair will begin to be open and transparent about their plans, because so far we are the only party with a plan for investment in Canadians and in the growth that we need.
So you're giving us an economic outlook for the next 4 years. I'm wondering, obviously that's built on some sort of sense of when the economy is going to turn around. When do you expect things to improve?
We're basing our fiscal projections on the Parliamentary Budget Officer's report in the short term and on the Department of Finance's own projections for the longer term. But we know the economy will improve when the Canadian government starts investing once again in the kinds of things that will create growth.
How much worse would the economy have to get for you to run a deficit that was even bigger than $10 billion?
We've based our projections on the Parliamentary Budget Officer's report of the past month and a half, and we've even been building into that projection the worsening that we've seen since his projection came out. We know that we will be balancing the budget in 2019, and the way to do that is to make the necessary investments in the growth and infrastructures that Canadians need. That's what we're focused on, and that's what we will continue to do.
Good morning, Mr. Trudeau.
Yes.
Can you fairly describe the proposed deficits as stimulus spending, and what sort of guarantee can you give that this will not be a structural deficit, structural changes to the federal government that will create ongoing deficits?
We saw stimulus spending in the very deep recession in 2008. this is not stimulus spending on that level. This is a plan to invest in Canadians, invest in growing the economy. While we are in recession right now, we do not feel that the need is for the kind of massive stimulus that was needed in Mr. Harper's last recession. Our focus is on creating the growth necessary to actually get back into balance in 2019 and get us out of Mr. Harper's deficit. Mr. Harper has been unable to create the growth necessary to get beyond a structural deficit. That is the key to creating strong economies, is to have growth to get out of deficits, not cuts. Mr. Harper hasn't understood that, and that's why we are confident that we will be balancing the budget in 2019 because of the growth we will be creating in the coming years.